Welcome to Audubon at Home. My name is Ianna, and today we are going to read a story called Octopus Alone. Octopus lay hidden in her cozy cave, enjoying the scene outside. Turtle chased squid, squid chased shrimp. The puffer was getting nervous with all the chasing going on. Then Octopus saw the seahorses bobbing along outside. One little one peeked in, then another, and another. The seahorses found Octopus fascinating, but she was shy and did not like to be noticed. She tried to shoo them away, but they thought she was playing, so they played too. "I give up," Octopus sighed. Squeezing out of her cave, she crawled into the garden. She changed colors just like that and disappeared. The seahorses swam away, wondering where she'd gone. Sea snakes slithered in and out of holes. Among the swaying anemones, baby dominoes played hide and seek, while clownfish chased butterflies. Tiny fish ate algae from a big fish's scales, leaving them sparkling clean. Octopus was about to pounce on a juicy lobster when she saw the little seahorses coming her way. She went perfectly still. The lucky lobster slid into a crevice. When the seahorses weren't disturbing her, they were delightful to watch. They wiggled and twirled, and one even did somersaults. It looked like so much fun. It was hard for Octopus to keep still, but she did, and the merry seahorses moved on. Octopus crept over to a thicket of stars. Jellyfish drifted past and headed beyond the reef. "Where do they go?" She gazed at the shimmering shapes. Suddenly, she had a funny feeling. The seahorses were staring. For how long, she wondered. She inked the water to hide her blushing and took off. She wanted to get away, far from googling eyes. After a while, she spied something interesting, a box full of delicious crabs. Octopus squished herself into the cage, but the crabs began pinching. She fiddled with the door and it opened. Out tumbled the frantic crabs. Octopus was about to grab a few when she had another funny feeling. A hungry eel was about to strike. Octopus squirted a cloud of ink and swam and swam and swam. When she finally stopped, she was far beyond the reef. Here, the water was gloriously empty. No one watching. No one to hide from. Whale songs rose faintly from the deep. Octopus remembered the dancing seahorses. She wiggled. She twirled. She even did a somersault. She was so happy to be alone. Then she felt a rumbling in the waters below. Whoosh! A whale surged past, up and out of the water. Whoa, look at that whale! Octopus nestled into a nook and found herself in a cave much like her own, except this one was away from everyone and everything. The whale crashed back down, leaving a magnificent storm of bubbles. The whale song faded into the distance until all was quiet. Exhausted, Octopus fell asleep. When Octopus awoke, she went outside. A lone jellyfish drifted by. No one was around to disturb her in this wonderful, quiet place. But after some time, she began thinking about the lively reef with its graceful anemones and slinking sea snakes. Most of all, she wondered what the seahorses were up to. "I'd better go home and find out," she said, hurrying along. She grabbed a snack on the way. When Octopus reached the reef, one little seahorse welcomed her home, then another, and another. Octopus was glad to be back with her friends. The end. Thank you for joining us for Audubon at Home.